A popular opinion says to not use the pickle class on a data given by user because on deserialization it may lead to the object injection attack and malicious code execution. But what about other formats? Are they also dangerous? My name is Kacper Szurek, and in today's episode of From Zero to Pentesting Hero, I am going to talk about YAML files. So, why the programmers decide to use this format? Some of them would raise the argument about readability. This format forces data storage in individual lines. It also allows you to merge changes easier. For example, if you use a version control system, such as Git, it's easier to edit a code broken into single lines than a JSON file, especially when it's not formatted and visible to the user as a one long string in one line. Let's look at today's example. We read the contents of the test YAML file using the YAML load function and then display the name. Everything works properly, but the YAML format is not as simple as it might seem. In standard use case, it recognizes the type of data that is assigned to it. Sometimes, however, we would like to have control over the type stored in the configuration. That's why tags exists, that is, commands starting with an exclamation mark. Thanks to them, we can choose the type explicitly. Just like here, the value of 0, the dot and 5 is going to be treated as a string and not as a float. In YAML, we can also store binary files, saving them using base64 encoding and using the tag double exclamation mark binary. Some parsers implement language-specific tags, and in Python, we can define tuple with the Python tuple tag. So where is the vulnerability today? In the standard parser used in Python, we can also use the apply tag, which allows you to call any function from any module and pass appropriate parameters to them. So it is equivalent to the ability to execute arbitrary code on the server that we attack. In our case, we will use the os.system function that lists the contents of the current directory. Now, instead of the user's name, we can see the contents of the directory. How to protect yourself against this vulnerability? Replace load with safe load. Then all dangerous tags will stop working. It's a pity that this is not the standard way this function works, because I think that many people do not realize the danger. And that's all in this episode. If you like it, subscribe my channel and leave a comment. See you next time.